Hey guys, it's Kara, and I'm back with another video. I am sick right now, so this is very chill today, but I'm excited to do it. It's unpopular opinions. I'm just going to be reacting to the ones that I got on my Instagram. I didn't get that many. I tried to ask for more, but my engagement has been absolutely horrific. I don't even know how to describe it. Like, people see the following, but they don't see just the fact that nobody's looking at my posts. So I'm not getting engagement, I'm not getting responses, but you guys who don't follow me on Instagram should follow me and go to the link in the description, and we can totally do a lot more like interactive stuff on my story and respond to those, because I'd love to hear what you guys have to say. But yeah, we're gonna just react to the ones that I did get, and even if the video is pretty short, it's still gonna be a fun time. And this is chill. Like, I just have my little sick starter kit. I have my water bottle, which is empty right now. I have some vitamin C, and I have the book I'm reading, which is so good beyond words. Like, I can't even describe it, but I have Redeeming Six. I own all the books now, so I just like have the cover, but I've been reading it on my Kindle instead, just because the book is like massive. So I have my little cute little Kindle. And I'm ignoring all my responsibilities, which is maybe not a good thing, but I just don't have the energy to get up. I don't know. I think it's because I've been overworking myself and not getting enough sleep, but that's another thing for another time. Let's just do the unpopular opinions now. All right, so we have some mixture of things. So we have some specific type of unpopular opinions, like about specific books, and then we have ones that are more general. So most of these in the first set are just specific ones. The first one is, I am a certified Nesta hater, and yes, I've read Akasif, which is A Court of Silver Flames by Sarah J. Maas. Sarah J. Maas is not an author I've talked about a lot on this channel, but my opinion of her is that she's okay, like, she's fine, and it has nothing to do with, like, all the different controversial things that have come up. I just think that some of her books were really good, and I personally like Akasif a lot. It was my favorite out of all the books I've read by her. I gave it a 5. I don't know what it was, but that's the one that most people hate on, but I loved it. And then I loved Court of Thorns and Roses. I gave that a 4.5, but then the ones in between, for some reason, and those are the ones that are the favorites, those are the ones that a lot of people loved, and I just found kind of boring and okay. And I want to give it another chance, but at the same time, she's kind of in the controversial side, so I don't know if I should step back into the series, because I've heard some things about it, and I just don't want to have to deal with all the drama. But about the comment about being a certified Nesta hater, I get it. I think in the first couple of books, it was kind of just, like, she just kind of got on my nerves. I personally loved her in the latest book, A Court of Silver Flames. I connected a lot, and I just liked her character by then, so I will have to say I don't agree with this one, but I understand why some people still feel the way that they do. Then we have, I don't mind dog-eared books at all, and I dog-ear my books. They show books' history and passage through time for real. No. I have to disagree. I used to dog ear my books, and going back to like my Dork Diaries books, because I reread one from the series every month, I see the dog ear creases and I can't do it. Like, it just ruins the book, and I'm kind of a perfectionist, so I think all the other little marks on my books, besides annotating, if the annotations don't come out right, then yeah, I'm upset. But like, if they're aesthetic and pretty, cool. But then if you're folding pages, if you're ripping stuff, if you're like just completely ruining the book, and then if a book comes damaged and dented, I can't do that. Like, I get that like there's a history behind it for some people, but no way. Like, I could not even bear to see a book like folded. Ugh, it's like, it's a lot. I do mind it. Then we have ACOTAR is overrated. So we're back to A Court of Thorns and Roses. And I assume that this person was talking about the whole series. And if they're talking about the whole series, then I agree. I think something about it, I had such high expectations. I thought it would be like the best book in the world. And it didn't end up being that way. I don't know what it is, but like, I just didn't feel like it was all that amazing. I thought it was like decent. And there are some good characters, some fun times, but like, something about fantasy, it's always a hit or miss for me. And it was some hits in the series and some misses, like always, I think, with my fantasy books. So yeah, I agree with this one. It's kind of overrated. Then we have one about Shadow and Bone. It's Shadow and Bone is a basic and kind of boring fantasy series. I agree with this one. And I think that's the reason why I haven't watched the show yet. And I know like everybody's watched the show, even people who haven't read the series. But I read the series and I really just wasn't a fan. I thought it was boring. I just haven't connected to any of Leigh Bardugo's books. So I have to say that like it was just kind of boring. And I also did not like the whole love triangle situation, especially how Mal was. Mal, if you guys get this, like you got it. Like you know how it goes. But Aspen from the Selection series and Gale from the Hunger Games are in the same font as Mal. It's like it's the other guy in the love triangle. They're kind of just awful, and the author has to make them that way so that the other one looks better. And that's sort of what Mal was, except he did not make the other guy look better. Like, neither of them were good. I think Alina should have chosen herself. So, I don't know. Like, I just think it was kind of boring. The only good thing of Shadow and Bone is Nikolai. So, yeah, that's my two cents. Oh, so we have some more. We have some more opinions. I thought there were only a little bit, but we have a good amount. So then we have Colleen Hoover is overrated and overhyped. That's not even an unpopular opinion anymore. It's just the popular opinion. And I have to say that, like, and this happens with most of authors that I'll talk about. I almost never have one strong feeling when there's a controversial author. I'm never like in the hit or in the miss category. I'm always in the middle. And that's how I feel about Colleen Hoover. I love some of her books. I love some of her books, but I also hate some of her books. And I think that's why last year's average rating for like all the books I read in the year, the stats were so low and they were lower than they've ever been just because some of the books, it was like the books, like I've never read any books worse than some of the ones I've read. But those only apply to kind of like the not as popular books she's written. And then as for the popular ones, most of them I did really enjoy, so I do kind of feel like conflicted. I do have to say that she's not the only author in the world, and I get why people are upset because when she was really popular, everybody was like, oh my gosh, like this is the best person ever, best author. She writes exquisite books, and she has a mixed bag like any other author. So I do feel like no, she's not the best author in the world, but I don't think any author is absolutely perfect. And I do feel like it's becoming a trend to just hate on her. And I think it's kind of frustrating because when I have opinions that are positive about some of her books, I don't feel like I have a safe place to just say that. Like, my opinion is that sometimes they're good. Like, she has some toxic boys in her books, but it's not a bad thing to have bad characters and good characters. It's just some of them you are not like sure if they should be the villain or the hero because she makes them the hero. That's not a good thing, but some of them they're not the hero and they're acknowledged to be bad and people are still complaining. Like, books are supposed to have flawed characters, in my opinion. Not every book should be like perfect sunshine and rainbows. And so I don't know, I'm still rambling, but I just feel like the whole hate train on her is a bit excessive, even though I do understand why some people just don't really like her that much. So yeah, it's kind of mixed for me. This one is another specific one. The Night Circus is better than many books in Book Talk. I mean, books like The Song of Achilles and It Ends With Us. I haven't read The Night Circus, so I'm not gonna say much on this. I wasn't a fan of Song of Achilles, but I did really love It Ends With Us, so I don't know. But The Night Circus is a fantasy book, and I've heard really good things about it. So I guess I'm just like nervous because they can sometimes be super slow and then I end up not really being a fan, but hopefully it's different with this one. Don't mind my really weird voice right now. It's kind of like weird and scratchy, but yeah, I'm still sick. I just really wanted to do this video. Okay, next one is breaking spines is natural process of reading. And I agree. I agree with this one. I have a lot of thick books, like for example, Redeeming Six. This book is 1,000 pages. So it's one of the biggest books I own. The text is just small, which is why it's not bigger than it could have been. And of course, if I were to read it the physical way, which I will this year because I'm going to reread the whole series and annotate it since she's not releasing any more books in the series until next year. But anyway, I will be cracking the spine, and I did it for From Blood and Ash and other books on my shelf that are like this thick because you can't avoid it. Like, you just can't avoid it. It's definitely a part of reading, especially if the books are not floppy paperbacks and they're not like this thin. So it's just like, why try to barely open the book when you can just crack the spine? And I know what I said earlier about the dog-eared pages, but to me, this is different because that's the only acceptable way to not damage the inside of the book and make it look weird. Because it's like you're cracking the book's back. Just think about it like that. Like, it's not that big of a deal. I like it. Then we have, I'm not a fan of Greek mythology books. And that's interesting. I wonder if she's read Percy Jackson and if she also doesn't like those. But to be honest, I agree with this mostly. I thought Percy Jackson was fun, but then otherwise, Greek mythology is so confusing and fantasy is already confusing on its own. I feel like with all Greek mythology books, there's this expectation that you have to know what most of the gods are the gods of or goddesses of, and then you'll be confused if you don't know that ahead of time. So it's kind of just annoying, and I'd just rather read a regular fantasy book at that point because it's just too much background knowledge most of the time. So yeah, I agree with this one. Then we have November 9 by Coho is awful. That's one of the books by her that I loved. It ended up being my favorite book by her when I first read it. I read it a second time, but not when the hatred for November 9 started coming out. And then after I read it the second time, I still loved it. And then there's hate for it and a lot of things like, oh, Ben is problematic, which is true looking back, but I don't know. I feel like I had a really good time reading it and I feel so guilty. But I'm not going to read it again just because I don't want to have to go through it again and then be like, oh, I am really dumb for thinking that this book was good. I'm just going to continue to promote and love All Your Perfects by Colleen Hoover because that one was perfect, like it says in the title. So that's the only one that I'm going to like really hype up. November 9, if somebody asks me a question about it, I'm not going to say I don't like it and lie like some people are kind of doing online. But I'm just going to not really bring it up anymore and talk about the books that I've been loving that are not by her, I guess. Then we have A Little Life Just Shouldn't Exist. This is a book that I've been terrified to read because I've heard amazing things and awful things. A Little Life sounds really depressing, really sad, and I can take my share of it, but there are some books that I'm not going to mention. Because I already mentioned the author and I told you about how she's a mixed bag, but there's a book and multiple books out there where it's just too heavy. And I'm wondering if this is going to be one of those or if it's going to be handled properly. So I've kind of been like avoiding it at all costs, but I will continue to kind of do research on it because maybe it will be for me. It's just seems kind of like super, super sad, and I don't know how much it's gonna be for me. Then we have Too Much Smut Makes a Book Worse, and Penelope Douglas is a horrible writer. I agree with the first part. The second part, I want to agree, even though I haven't read any of her books, just because the premises of most of them just doesn't seem like my thing. But for the first point, I agree. I do read a lot of romance, so it does come up. But I hate if the whole book is like that. I only want like it to make sense. Because if the whole book is like that, there's no emotional connection, and I only care about the emotional connection. So that's just like what comes with it, I feel like. So I usually skim those, to be honest. Like sometimes I'll like read it, but sometimes I'll just skim it, especially if it's just a chapter or two. What I care about is the build up, the emotional build up, the angst. Like that is what makes romance good. So I agree. Then we have Friends to Lovers is better than Enemies to Lovers. I agree. I've talked about this on my channel, but Enemies to Lovers is not my favorite because it's just never done correctly. I've never read a book. I think I read one book, maybe, and that's The Cruel Prince, that has done Enemies to Lovers right. And that's only because The Cruel Prince, the first book, there was no lovers. I'm only on the first book, so I don't even know. But otherwise, people just call anything where they're like mad at each other enemies. And that is especially the case in romance books and with contemporary, like realistic fiction romance. It's almost never enemies because enemies is so like severe and serious. And then after chapter two, they're like, I'm starting to like them. And like, it's just so unrealistic. Like, don't call it enemies to lovers and don't market it as enemies to lovers because you're just gonna let me down every single time. But then with fantasy does do it, I feel like. It's just, I haven't read a lot of them. But the point is, Friends to Lovers will always have my heart. And childhood Friends to Lovers is my favorite trope ever. So I have to be biased to Friends to Lovers at all times. Then we have Julian in the Magnolia Parks universe series, literally does nothing, and I don't know why people like him. I have to agree with this for the most part. The latest book, Daisy Hates the Great Undoing, it again, I've been reading a lot of really good books. This book was maybe one of my favorite books of all time. And I really liked reading his perspective in this one, but I still don't feel like I like him as a character. I just appreciated getting his kind of two cents because when I read the book before it, we had gotten a different perspective and he just seemed like an awful person with no redeeming qualities. But it seemed a little better in this latest book. So I have to, although I do have to agree, I feel like it was nice that we got to see a little more about him. So yeah, I do agree with this a little bit. We only have like two more and they're both ones that I kind of just covered, but I'm gonna like expand on them. Someone was like, super explicit scenes take you out of the story, and some book boyfriends are just kind of gross. First point, I already said I agree with. And then the second point, it's true. I think with the Twisted series, that was especially true. I felt like, oh my gosh, all of a sudden, it's like they are the weirdest, most possessive people. They're like, you're mine. And like, everybody's like, oh, they're so perfect. They did nothing wrong. But then I just feel really uncomfortable. So yeah, I do agree with this one. And then the next one is something that is a spoiler for Magnolia Parks. And I really want you to skip if you want to read the series, which you should. If you haven't read the series, and I mean the entire series because you need to read all the books to know this fact, skip to the timestamp I put on the screen, please. Please and thank you. I don't want anybody to be spoiled. But this one is, I hate Julian Hates. I think it's his fault that Bridget is dead. I agree. I almost forgot about the fact that he was kind of responsible. That was really sad, and I'm still not over it. I need the next book now. I need like closure. But yeah, it's just awful because that was Magnolia's sister, and he constantly put people in harm's way. He never stopped doing what he did with all the selling and all these really gang type stuff that are not really safe. And he claimed to really love Magnolia, but then to go around and continue to put her in harm's way and to put Daisy in harm's way is really frustrating. And he's definitely not my favorite character. I do think his perspective is important to have, but I just really don't like him. And I completely understand the struggle to really appreciate his character because it's just so frustrating with him most of the time. That was all for today's video. Like and subscribe, and I know I was sick and I look kind of weird, but like comfies are really comfortable and I need that for right now. And also, I think the audio was better this time, which is good. And that's really great, and I will continue to do this because I think the audio will be better for everyone when they have headphones on and they're trying to turn up the volume. They don't need to turn it up that much. So let me know what you think about the new audio or anything else. Follow me on Instagram, link is in the description, and comment down below any opinions you have about the opinions I mentioned. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.